H.P. Lovecraft prefaces in the introduction of supernatural horror in literature that the oldest and strongest emotion of mankind is fear, and the oldest and strongest kind of fear is the fear of the unknown. And while not being a contested statement or even especially peculiar, what is, in fact, is that these feelings are sought after in artistic or literary mediums. I can say a lot about an individual. To willingly seek out such harsh and abrasive mindscapes in pursuit of understanding imposing feelings within yourself is admirable, to say the least. You know, and tapping into these uneasy feelings is what leaves the longest-lasting impression, and also what Lovecraft does best. One of the most impressionable aspects of media is atmosphere. And like the literal name suggests, it's not seen, but felt. How one felt during a specific work, the imagery or the aesthetic, lingers around long after its completion, when done right. And arguably one of the most Lovecraftian animes, crafted with love, a love letter to Lovecraft, is 1985's Angel's Egg. Finally, anime fans and Lovecraft fans can rejoice in commonality for their shared love for tentacles. This is what Lovecraft himself had to say about constructing an otherworldly sense of foreboding and terror. A certain atmosphere of breathless, unexplainable dread of outer, unknown forces must be present, and there must be a hint, expressed with a seriousness and portentousness becoming its subject, of the most terrible conception of the human brain, a malign and particular suspension or defeat of those fixed laws of nature which are our only safeguard against the assaults of chaos and demons of unplumbed space. Angel's Egg fits this description holistically. Forces beyond human comprehension govern the very world they live in, and efforts to combat such an existence are shown to be helpless or hopeless for its occupants. And there's a lot to say about the ambience and delivery of Angel's Egg, but without getting into spoilers, I mainly wanted to talk about one scene in particular that exemplifies Lovecraftian's dreadful depiction of desperation and calamity for resolve over the unknown, and also because it contained fish.
It's not even pink!
In a world that can only really be described as suffocating, as though underwater, the town's residents pour their efforts into hunting these mere shadows of sea creatures, unseen to them, and also us as the viewer. Only silhouettes of the creatures are ever shown, and the efforts to apprehend them are futile. And the more they try, the more destruction they cause around them, making it very apparent that these, like, weak humans really have no idea what they're dealing with. Even the means of retaliation are displayed as flawed, and without real understanding, blind in a sense. To explain the brilliance of this scene, we can compare it to something like Plato's allegory of the cave, where Plato describes teaching philosophy to those unwilling or unable to comprehend him as blinded by abstraction, not able to see reality for what it is, but a reflection of it. The story depicts men that live out their entire lives chained inside of a cave, facing a wall as shadows from a fire behind them cascade silhouettes of reality before them, their one and only view of reality. One of the men is later set free outside, and as he takes in all the nuances and complexities of the world, he returns back to the cave to explain his heightened understanding to the others, only to be met with dismay and rejection of something that is unable to be mentally comprehended, the unknown. In Angel's Egg, what isn't explicitly spoken is left up for interpretation through the environment and set pieces. And considering Angel's Egg barely has any spoken dialogue, you'll be just as confused maneuvering around the dreary world as our bong water drinking protagonist. Since the unknown is shrouded in such mystery, in Angel's Egg, the metaphor to the fear of the unknown plays a strong religious role. In search of ultimate wisdom, you know, understanding of all, religion is the substitute, one that facilitates sanity amidst the terror of reality. It's one of the main messages in Angel's Egg, an answer to existential dread, that religion is unique to humankind, insofar as that enables finding solitude in the otherwise unfamiliar and unknown. Only that too is an illusion cast on a cave wall, accepted blindly in pursuit of understanding something beyond human knowledge.
You guys ever watch the movie The Pianist? Pretty emotional movie, I think. Professional pianist in the midst of war, playing piano because he's a pianist. And he has a giant piano.